Welcome to the SWN Podcast. I don't know how I got my camera set up last road trip, but I seem to have set up even weirder this week. Yes, it's Billy. We're back on the road for the SWN Podcast. We're heading to Peterhead for Community Pro Wrestling in Peterhead, funnily enough. Peterhead Football Club, that's where it is. I have no idea where that is. I know where Peterhead is, so I am relying on my, well, sat nav, to be honest. I'm not gonna lie to you. It won't be my cunning. I've got like a stop off at Midlaw on the way, we're gonna get petrol, you know, all that fun stuff's happening that we've got going on. So this will be our first Community Pro Wrestling show. I won't be doing this whole intro won't be the full journey, because I think I'm like an hour and a half away from Peterhead, so nobody wants to hear me rattle on for that long. Just on my own anyway. Don't think a montage in the middle, maybe a Q&A segment at the end. So I think there's six matches announced. I'm trying to remember what the card is right now. I need to look at it before I hit record. So from what I remember, it is, here we go, but Ravy Davey versus Lee McRae. So Lee McRae, I think he's from Inverness, so he's fairly local. It's in the north. He's from the north anyway, northeast. Yeah, well, north-ish. So that's pretty cool seeing our local guy wrestling this weekend. So Ravy Davey versus Lee McRae. We've got the Govan Team Open Challenge. That's Steg and Xander in an Open Challenge tag team match. I'm really hoping that it's the Casino Brutale. I would love it if it's the Foundation guys. That would be nice if it was either Zach and Ryan or Brazer Brad Ryan or you know, let's round them all off, Brad and Zach. That would be pretty cool. Or I don't think it is, because I think he's away somewhere else, but Ronan King and Connor, the Aberdeen Dream Team, that would be nice to see take up the Open Challenge. So I don't know what that one's going to be like. Ellie Armstrong versus Nicole Jasmine, two wrestlers that I've really wanted to see wrestle live, so I'm excited for that. Ellie has still got my most favourite article on the SWN site, where she did her top 10 vegan options, which it just tickled me so much. I loved it. So yeah, I look forward to seeing them two doing the wrestling. We were supposed to have Big Ross Houser and the Big Strong Man Ewan Raw, but Ewan's not on the show. He's been replaced by, I'm trying to remember, I think his name's Charlie Watson, has replaced the Big Strong Man to take on Big Ross Houser. So, I haven't seen Big Ross wrestle live either. So a lot of these guys I haven't seen wrestle live. I think the only ones out of the list so far is Ravy Davey. That's about it. When he was doing rock and wrestle shows, I think that's the only one I've actually seen. I've seen Thatcher Wright. Thatcher Wright is defending the CPW Heavyweight Championship in a four-way, including Mayhem Brooks, of course, Elgin's own Mayhem Brooks, Darrow, and the Sam Barber Experience. So that should be pretty good. I haven't seen Sam again. Sam Barber is not someone I've seen wrestle live yet either. So this is a lot of fairly new faces. I think I've seen three of them live and in person. I've spoken to quite a lot of them through the podcast itself, so it's quite cool to actually see the people that you've interviewed live and in living colour. There is a possibility that I'm going to try and get some interviews again. Last week it was just a minute of me just going, hey look, I've got you, I've hit a quota, I've got you on the podcast, there we go, counts. So I'm hoping to get maybe a little bit more. I don't know who I'm going to get. I've been in touch with a few folk to possibly get on the podcast. It's just more timing. I mean, I am leaving Elgin at a ridiculously early time. It's like 1 o'clock, half past one. So I just need to see when I get to Peterhead and take it from there. So it's going to be a good one, I think. I've seen pictures of the venue, like the room that it's in. It's quite an intimate venue. It is at the Peterhead Football Club. Hopefully the weather stays nice. We'll get some shenanigans outside on the pitch or something like that. But looking forward to the second evening of wrestling. It's been a long time since a two-nighter for wrestling. I think possibly we'll have two two-nighters this year if all going to plan for W3L in Elgin in October. So yeah, but I don't know what, how much to say, because a lot of these guys, I've seen one or two community pro wrestling shows on YouTube, but a lot of these guys I haven't properly seen wrestle before. So I don't know, I don't want to begin with predictions. I know Big Ross has got a good winning streak, or he's lost very rarely. So I think Charlie Watson will have a bit of a hard time of it. Apologies if it's not Charlie Watson, it could be Charlie Wilson, but I think it's Watson. And I'm going to feel really bad about it. I'll correct myself in the end, so don't worry if I'm absolutely wrong about that. But yeah, it's going to be a good time. New promotion, so that's, what's that? That's my third promotion of the year, I suppose. WrestleZone, WCL, Community Pro. And then after that, I think I've got WrestleZone again, and then it's WrestleZone again, and then it's Fair City Wrestling. So I've got a good few promotions that I'm hitting this year, which I like. I like some variety. I like going to, when I can, go to different promotions. Of course, I mean, I would love to be able to go to wrestling every weekend, but you know, it's a cost of living crisis. I can't go down to Edinburgh willy-nilly. I can't go down to Glasgow willy-nilly. I've got to have pennies. I've got to be able to feed my kid. I've got to be able to feed myself, more importantly, in my brain there. So yeah, there's a lot of logistics. But I look forward to getting down to Dundee this year for Fair City Hardware Mania. So we're on the road. We're on the road trip. We'll maybe do some wee clippies here and there before we get to the actual montage and the aftermath. But I don't know how much more I can really pad this opening segment out. Looking forward to the same. I'm not going to do the whole journey because it's an hour and a half and I've only been recording for 7 minutes and we just went past Lump Bride. So, no, I haven't. Solid. I don't know where we are. I should know by now. So, I'm going to leave you for now. I might jump back in when I have a pit stop in Midlaw. I might not. I don't know. I might stop when I have a bit of tea. No, this is the fun thing about the road trip. I have no idea what's going to happen. I just hit record when I think, I'll do. And we take it from there. So, I'll see you in a bit. There we are, Peterhead Football Club. We are here way too early. It is about 3:30. So, I'm going to go and eat. Go find some food. But, fairly easy to find. With the aid of a sat-nav. We'll see if I can find a parking space anywhere near Bonbon. Because I drove past it like twice, that didn't really work. So I'll be back here in about, I don't know, 2 hours, something like that, 2.5 hours, I don't know, right. Fun. Huzzah. Let's go get some sweets. We're back, we've eaten at pretty much a Wetherspoons. Just done a, you don't need to know that. But yeah, so I've eaten. I'm back at the Peterhead Football Club ground. I'm hoping that there's a queue soon because I don't know where I'm supposed to queue, because I know it's not actually on the pitch. I have no idea where we can enter. But there's folk milling about, so surely I'll find out. I did forget a match. Of course I did, in the first opening bit. There's the Wanderer versus Ryan Richards. So I've never seen Ryan Richards, I've never seen the Wanderer wrestle live, so cool to see them live. A lot of new faces tonight. A lot of new faces that I'm seeing, and I'm looking forward to the show. So I'm going to go in, I'm just going to let my phone charge up a little bit, and then I'm going to head into the show. So next thing will probably, fingers crossed, be the montage. Possibly. We'll see you in a sec. If I want it, gotta make to myself a promise. I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top. Yo, no, I ain't the type to give up. If I do something, man, I do it till I get what I want. I turn a business out of nothing into something I love. I got a poker face, but honestly, I'm not one to bluff. I flip a switch, never miss, man, I always stay up. Don't let them see you, bitch, always have a plan to stay tough. This life ahead of you ain't easy, it was built to be rough.
on your shoulders. Now we ain't out here moving rocks, we out here moving boulders. Now we ain't getting posterized, we out here making posters. And we ain't got nothing to hide, we move forward like soldiers. You better wake up, pull the pay stub, or you'll pay up. Don't make love to the game, bruh, fuck the game up. Change up, rearrange stuff to your greatness. Same us for the way up, play the game, bruh.
Never stop, I'll get it if I want it. Gotta make to myself a promise. I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top, yeah.
You know I'm always honest. There ain't no way I'm ever stopping.
I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top,
I'm always learning with pain. She likes to hurt me and maim. I'm always working to change, but she's still lurking the same. I keep on building a dynasty while the haters be trying me. But they hate from inside, you see, hate themselves in society. So I let them speak quietly while my actions speak quietly.
Here I am at a football stadium doing interviews.
I'm joined by Big Ross Houser.
Hello.
Hello. You got a big win tonight over Charlie Watson?
Yes, I did, yeah.
Yeah. You're supposed to be against Euro Raw.
The big strong man.
Yeah. So did you have to prepare anything different?
Big cowardly man tonight.
I don't know, they want to come up here because it's beautiful today.
Oh, it's great here.
Yeah. So what's it like actually wrestling in a football stadium? That's pretty cool.
That's a pretty cool thing to say.
Yeah. Bucket list stuff. It's been a while since I've had you on the show, and since then you're just tearing up at Community Pro. And
mm-hmm.
Is there
last time Community Pro just started?
Was, yeah. Is there anyone that you're wanting to, because it doesn't keep you pinned, you haven't submitted yet, is it all just, it's been count out or DQs?
Yeah, just one count out, yeah.
So
in the tournament.
So who you want in Community Pro? Who's going to step up to Big Ross? Who are you going to call out?
Who am I wanting? I'm not sure, but I've beaten most people. Last time I said I wanted Andy Wilde, and I faced him and beat him. Andy Roberts now, sorry.
That's a weird time.
It was Andy Wilde.
A weird Andy Wilde t-shirt for some reason.
Yeah. And what did I say last time? Leighton as well. Yeah. But he won't be here much longer.
I know.
He's away in Japan.
Absolutely.
Big things.
We're seeing that at the moment. We're seeing a lot of guys, Jack Morris, Leighton Buzzard, all going to Japan. Is that something that you kind of want him to do? Big strong style stuff?
I do like the Japan style, especially the 80s All Japan style. And early 90s All Japan. I faced him in tag team action. I wouldn't mind facing Ronan King one on one.
Oh,
or Judas Gray. Yeah, either of them.
Excellent. I'm sure people would like to actually see them two get battered as well, which will help.
I faced the two of the Foundation of the Future. Maybe the other one.
Oh, Brad. Brad would be a.
Yeah, he's one of the only people who's been able to take me off my feet.
Oh, that would be something. Hopefully next time Peterhead we'll see a couple of guys from up here as well, because so I'm gonna let you go, so we'll keep you a couple of minutes because I know that you have to check on Darryl as well. Hopefully your travel back will be a little less eventful than coming up, because it's a fair trek up to Peterhead.
It's a 3.5 hour drive up.
God,
hopefully quicker on the way back down.
Here's me moaning about an hour and 20, hour and a half coming up here. But no.
These long trips are fun, even more fun than the short ones, because you get, this is just a day with the roster and you have all the
body experience.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Perfect, well thank you very much for taking time to speak to me.
Yeah.
So I'm back in the stands of Peterhead, never seen a football game here, with Ellie Armstrong. I'm very excited to have you on here.
I'm very excited to finally meet you in person. Yeah,
because last time we spoke, you maybe only had a handful of matches. You were a sub-in.
I think I had three, genuinely, for the closed-door tapings.
Absolutely. Yeah, was it? Yeah, because you were a sub-in last minute. I was like, I need someone to speak to. You volunteered, and here we are. And now you're WWE Network, doing great Iron Girders as well. And you've written probably my favourite article on the website.
Yes, which I'm going to do a part two for takeaway food. Fast food takeaway food. I'm going to write that for you.
I can't wait. So if anyone hasn't seen it, it's the top 10 vegan options, alternatives. And it's the best thing, because it's just... I like that when wrestlers just do their own kind of... what they like. I keep trying to get people to do video game ones.
Yeah, well, you know. We need to get arcade violence on that.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. So, Peterhead, it was about 3 hours, was it 3 hours to go up here?
Well, I've got the bladder of a child, so it took us a bit longer in the car because I kept having to stop. So, yeah, it took us about 4 hours to get up here with pit stops in Dundee and random service station. So,
say that, I actually like Dundee.
But I've never been, I've driven through this bit of the world, but I've never actually been to this bit, this part of Scotland. So this is my first time up here. I've been to Inverness, obviously you go the other way. So. It's my first time here. It's beautiful. For it today.
Yeah, because well, when I left Elgin, it was raining, so I was so glad when it got to here. I was like, oh, thank God, because I thought it'd be awkward doing these little bits just in front of everybody.
Absolutely dripping with rain down here.
It was absolutely as well, but great match tonight. Really enjoyed it. You did win.
I mean, I'm going to take it up with CPW management because I am pretty sure that was a two count. I think my shoulder was up. I'm not a chicken. I'm not a chicken. My shoulder was up, she didn't pin me. I'm still the most dominant woman in CPW and I'll get my victory back. I'm still waiting for that women's title belt in CPW and I think it's got my name on it.
Absolutely.
So I will be speaking to CPW management next, tomorrow morning.
So you've got CPW, you've got Iron Girders.
Yep.
You've rattled through a good list of women's wrestlers in Scotland now. I think you must have faced just about all of them.
Yes.
But is there anyone that you're still angling for? But not just Scotland, UK?
I think the women's roster in the Scottish scene is amazing. And there's three women in Scottish wrestling that I've not wrestled yet in any capacity. And that is Serena, Debbie Dammer, and Emerson Jane, and I want them. So, I would love to wrestle them.
Maybe back to Dundee then, Fair City.
Back to FCW, maybe get my first Discovery match. Discovery's before I even started training, they were my favourite shows to go to. I would love to wrestle for Discovery. But anywhere, bring them to CPW, bring them to Iron Girders. I would love to wrestle those three ladies. Outside of the Scotland, give me anyone. I've wrestled some of the best from outside Scotland. Alexis Falcon, I wrestled her on ICW, and that's probably one of my best matches. But there is an absolute. Oh, I will. Okay. No, I'm not. I will wrestle anyone in the
room. She got beat.
I didn't get beat.
She got beat.
I tried
to.
You were
cheating.
No, I wasn't. I wrestled Freya.
She got beat. You don't know how to wrestle. She got cheated.
I'll wrestle you.
Oh, go on, that's me. Oh, go on, then. How scary is that?
Right, I think we'll leave it there because we're just getting called here by children. But no, thank you very much for.
No, thank you for coming to. Was this your first CPW show?
First CPW show.
The best one to come to.
Absolutely.
Where I got you.
Thank you very much.
No, I enjoyed that.
I'm back in front of the pitch this time. And I've got the Sad Barber Experience.
SBX.
SBX.
Oh, there's a pushing punches like a ghetto.
Like, man, I'm filming top quality content right now, so you just get to it. Right?
So this is how these interviews are going down with children coming in and trying to interrupt. But glad to come up to Peterhead, finally get the SBX experience myself here. So what was it like wrestling in front of
Peterhead? I'm affronted that I got asked to come back.
You got beat?
I got beat. I almost had him, almost won the title.
But you did it.
Almost were your new CPW
heavyweight
champion. But no, I got choked by Mayhem Brooks, didn't I? Ridiculous. See, if that was a one-on-one, I would have won. I'd be a new champ. But back in Peterhead, and so I tell you, I'm not coming back. It's a disgusting place for disgusting people.
Well, your hair's even more disgusting.
Aye, very good, big man.
Yeah, that big sweaty ginger.
Bobby, that's your signature.
It is, I know.
Bobby, I think you were
a question.
By the way, yes.
Can I show your coat?
So would you say that you've been here, you probably have driven up the handsome ratio up?
Yeah, 100%. Yes. Hey, off the pitch.
Pitch invader!
This is
see, cretins here, absolute cretins here. Don't listen to a word
ginger's
that I say.
Ginger's here, the yucky,
ginger.
Sweaty.
I'm ginger.
How long did it take you to come up with that one?
I'm ginger.
Aye, very
I'm ginger.
Good.
I'm ginger.
Can I push you?
No, absolutely ginger. Not.
Yeah, anyway. Pitch side, Peterhead. I don't know how I'm going to end the first part, but Peterhead is an interesting place. So you're still doing Community Pro. How are you finding your journey of Community Pro going? Is Thatcher Wright going to be again in your sights?
Whoever's got the belt is going to be in SBX sights. So SBX should be the face of Community Pro Wrestling. Tonight he could have been the CPW champion and it would have brought the market value of CPW up astronomically. But no, because SBX, Ravy Davy knew that SBX is a threat to Thatcher Wright, so he put me in a four-way. He put SBX in a four-way for the title. And my odds go drastically down in a four-way, and I almost had the title.
Maybe next time.
Maybe next time. Could have been the face at CPW.
Thanks very much for taking the time to speak to me. Hopefully next time you come to Peterhead, if you come back.
Honestly, I don't know if I will. See if you turn around.
Yep.
These guys are the reason SBX is never coming back to Peterhead. Ridiculous. Ridiculous treatment of the most handsome man in Scottish entertainment, SBX.
Positivity. I feel like we all just hate on everything, it's killing me. Thoughts build quick, causing different possibilities. Negative thoughts will cause different disabilities. So do better, work hard under pressure. If you got no time, work smarter than ever. Don't ever let them tell you that you can't ever say never. And turn your mind into the truest to go-getters.
Never stop, I'll get it if I want it. Gotta make to myself a promise. I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top, yeah.
You know I'm always honest. There ain't no way I'm ever stopping.
I won't quit, keep going till I got it. I won't give up till I'm on top, yeah.
I'm joined post-show, we're still here at Peterhead Football Club. I'm joined by Martin McAllister, another past guest of the podcast. Thank you for joining us, thank you for coming up. You weren't announced?
Nope, it was a last minute thing, bit of a surprise. I was hoping I'd be able to surprise the fans with my first win, but not to be.
But how's Peterhead, well obviously I didn't come away with a win, but how's Peterhead treated you?
It's been fantastic to be here. I don't get to wrestle up with Millie enough, so this was absolutely fantastic, and I hope I come back.
Yeah,
I hope we get the win next time.
I hope so too. I can't wait. I don't know when Ravy's going to plan it. It sounds like he's just going to make it up as it goes along. But hopefully, next time you come up here, you've got a couple of wins under your belt, or just get the first one and let everyone enjoy it. But thanks very much for enjoying us. Just a couple seconds, just for ground folk, because I know you want to get up the road and get home, because I know it's a couple hours away. But
awesome.
Again, thanks very much.
Yeah.
So I am joined by Ryan Richards, Supreme. I've somehow got a hold of him. So thank you for joining me. I'm looking forward to speaking to you. It's Peterhead. It's been a lovely night here. You picked up a win. And what are your thoughts on that?
As expected, Barry. I come here every time. I dominate. I win. I'm the guy that everybody pays to see. It's just another night for me.
Wonderful. It's an honour for me to get to see you for the first time wrestling live.
I'm sure it is. I'm sure it's a pleasure to see me.
Absolutely. And what's your plans next? What's your 5-year plan? I'm sure you've got one.
So far, I've dominated in Scotland. I've been in the biggest promotions against the biggest people. So next, maybe I go out to Scotland. Maybe Europe. Maybe United States. I think the world needs to see how great I am.
Wonderful. I won't take up too much of your time, but thank you very much for joining me.
How much are you getting paid for this?
About that, and nothing. And that's it. That's a wrap from Community Pro Wrestling in Peterhead. I have had an absolute blast. The show finished at like 9 as well, which is always a bonus when I'm travelling back, and when these guys are travelling back as well. This is the awkward moment where I have to drive past a bunch of them because I've been hanging in my car for a bit, speaking to Kelly. So I'm hoping the speed bumps don't actually knock the camera as well, so let's find out. So yeah, we've got a bunch of interviews, as you will have seen, during the interval and at the end of the show. Some
all were great. There is one I'm going to have to, like, butcher when it comes to editing, which will be the one with the Sam Barber experience. So if it's all going well, or if it's gone at all, it'll look glorious, or it'll look edited somehow. If it's not in the episode, it didn't go well. That was pretty much it. Nothing that Sam did was the issue, really. Oh no, nothing Sam did was the issue. That is fact. It was kids running up and shouting obscenities at SBX, which I can't put out. I can't put out because it was absolutely disgusting what they were saying. So yeah. The crowd, I don't know what it is with CPW shows. I honestly don't know, because the crowd are absolutely feral, and it can work. Sometimes it's amazing, sometimes it's absolutely magical. Now the other times we're stuck with kids being, to be honest, dicks. I don't know what they're being. So you got to take rough with the smooth, I suppose, at times when it comes to these shows. But they were loud, they were into it, they really wanted to see some wrestling, and I got to enjoy wrestling as well, so I got to enjoy a good show. I'll probably do a bit more of a breakdown from what I remember of the actual show itself once I get home, and I'll get into the old hashtag studio, the old SWN Towers. I've made a wrong turn, so this is a good start to my drive home. So yeah, I'll do a little bit more of a rundown itself. I'll just ramble for another couple of minutes before I figure out where I am. I don't have a pier head. That's about all I've got. Time center, so it must be. I'm gonna go this way. I'm gonna go to Bethel. So yeah, it was a really fun night. Raven Davey really puts on a community feeling show, not just for the actual content of the show itself. Oh, the camera's fallen. Not just for the content of the show itself, but really for the crowd, the wrestlers. It feels like a real, like, family show for them, as well as the fans that are coming to the show. They're, yeah, went the right way. Yeah, so when the main event was happening, it was a 10-man tag elimination match. And I was hoping to get a hold of Leighton Buzzard for the show. It didn't happen, unfortunately. But I've got to see his he got a farewell speech from Raven Davey. And during that match, it was chaos, and the crowd were really into it as well. They just wanted to have fun and enjoy. And it obviously went everywhere around the venue. Went a little bit outside as well. It was just a really fun night of just good old fashioned family wrestling. It was just family friendly wrestling. The kids enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. What's not to love? So I got to meet a lot of the guys. I said I got a couple of interviews as well with a few of the folk from CPW. Very very thankful that they took a little bit of time to speak to me. Taking them to the stands, the Peterhead Football Club, and interviewing a couple of wrestlers. That's pretty cool. When it comes to that, I got to speak to a couple of guys. I wish I actually just grabbed them and put them onto the podcast as well. But you know, I'm getting tired, and I forgot, and I just like get overwhelmed with all the people speaking to me and there's the great compliments as well. People speak to me and got to talk about just how cool the podcast is, which is ace. It sounds like I'm tooting my own horn, which I am a little bit, but it was just ace to get that feedback, get people knowing the wrestlers are listening to the show is incredible. And thanks to Raven Dave as well. I've got a little list of folk that I want to get on in the future, that we will get on in the future, for either full 1 hour plus episodes or just like mini episodes. My schedule is looking now with trying to fit in interviews. It probably will be shorter form interviews, like half an hour or something like that. Just have to see what time I have, what time's allowed, what I can do but it's just something that I've got to bear in mind. But we're short 2 men to our road trip season. Actual show two. This will be the third episode of the season, which I'm terminated on the week before. And it's probably I called the episode Party in Peterhead because I like alliteration for my episodes as much as I possibly can. This was initially going to be called Peterhead Pandemonium, which I think was probably more accurate. But it was a great night. Leighton Buzzard, his last match in Community Pro Wrestling. I think his last actual match is in Scotland as of recording tomorrow. I think, I'm not sure. I'm probably lying there. But he certainly put on a show. It's great to see Leighton. It was actually proper, a bit emotional as well, with Ravy Davies' farewell speech, his dad came in and all that. And he actually had a wee lump in my throat. It was great to see Leighton Buzzard wrestle before he goes off to Japan. And best of luck to him. Like I said, I would have loved to have got him for a minute, but he was very popular with getting pictures. And I got a handshake from him, and that's all I could probably. That's probably all I could. I'm happy I got that. There we go, I'll go with that. So, next. Unfortunately, my car likes to tell me when I'm hit the lights in the middle of the road. That's where that beep has come from. So, next up is Battle of the Nations. I think the next episode that will come out will be my interview with Tommy Cross. Fingers crossed, because my internet has been absolutely horrific at home at the moment. But hopefully, the next episode should be with Tommy Cross. Not Tommy Cross. He's SCW, that's not right. With Oliver Green. I'm thinking of Green Power Ranger. That's it. So it should be with Oliver Green will be the next episode. And then it'll be Battle of the Nations. That'll be the next road trip. I'll show 3. Yes, that all sounds right. I don't have any other interviews booked in the books at the moment. I possibly might do. I've got a couple that are in the periphery being discussed. I've got a couple guys from Ruby Davey that you'd like to have on, so we'll get them arranged in the near future. And thanks to even the guys like the Pack, the GTT, because Xander having chats. I didn't get a recording of them, but I got to have a little chat with them. Same with Nicole Jasmine, got to have a little chat with Nicole Jasmine, which I didn't get a recording of. Darrow as well. So I've just been very lucky tonight. I was saying to Kelly when I was speaking to her before I've left to come home. This has felt like the most, like, as a professional night that I've done going to a show and speaking to people. Because I've never made a secret that I'm not a confident person, and I'm very anxious with people. But the atmosphere that Ravy Davies created with Community Pro Wrestling, it was just so easy for me just to speak to some of the wrestlers, just go, look, have you got a minute? Do you want to do a little bit of recording for my podcast? And it started off with like trying to do sit down interviews, as you would have seen, with Big Ross and with Ellie Armstrong. Eventually, I ended up just having to try and get a minute with people because there was just so many kids about, and there was just so many other factors that I just wanted to grab them for a minute, get them on, speak to them, and then let them get on with their day. Because they've got 3.5 hours to drive home. I've got 1:20, 1:45 if I hit traffic. So I can get home at a good hour. They can't. So and they've got a ring to go down. So it's been a wonderful night. I'm very aware that I'm rambling. This is probably going to be one of the bigger episodes because of my rambling, and because I got a lot of pictures taken for the montage. I got a lot of things done today. I didn't think I would get anything as many chats as I did. I was meant to get a chat with Darrow, but I chatted with him but didn't get a recording of it. I'm a very lucky boy. Very wanderer. Also got to speak to the wanderer. I'm a very lucky boy. Sorry, the other guys from the pack, Liam and I'm just remembering all these people that I spoke to tonight. Ruby Roberts was there. She was taking James referee, I don't know what his referee name is. James Blair. I got to speak to him as well. Nights like this remind me that I am a very lucky guy. That I am not a wrestler. I am not. I don't think I'm an important part of Scottish wrestling, but nights like this make me feel that I am. That I am a special part of Scottish wrestling, because the willingness for the wrestlers to speak to me and to just welcome me and say that the joy, Katia, sorry, I'm going to speak to Katia as well. They are so willing to speak to me and do the little 1 minute chats and do the Zoom recordings and do all that. God, I'm only to show three into the season, show two of the actual tour, and I'm already in a bit of an emotional mess. And I'm about to drive through a place where I used to live as well. So this is all very overwhelming night. So it's show two, next week's Battle of the Nations. I can't wait for that show. I don't know if I'm going to get anyone for chats. If I get anyone, I will be ecstatic. If I don't, I'm going to enjoy the show regardless, because we'll get I get to do the bits with Kelly. I love recording with Kelly, because it's just an absolute blast. She's my favourite person to go wrestling with. And she'll never hear this. She'll never hear this, so it's fine. I can say that without any recourse of saltiness. She's my favourite person to go wrestling with, so I get to go to Battle Nation with her. I don't know where I'm going. I'm proper rambling. I did live in Midlaw, lived in Upit Sligo. Not Aberdeen, I'm looking for Upit Sligo turn off. Upit Sligo. Here we go. You don't need to know this, you don't need this bit. But I've given it to you, because this is what the road trip episode's about. It's me just rambling for a bit, and you hopefully listening to some of it. But yeah, like I say, this will be probably a bigger one, because I got a lot of interviews. I'm hoping that Sam Barber experience, that SBX interview, I can do something with it. I think one bit of it I could probably send to Sam himself, and he can use it for his own needs. But if I don't have it in this episode, I'm going to put the unedited versions onto Patreon, because I can't put them out. You'll probably see why I can't put them out. But I'll put them on Patreon, so if you do, for whatever reason, want to get unedited versions of all my little interviews tonight. Oh god, can't wait anyway. Of all my interviews tonight, I'll put them on Patreon, and you can see them there. Right, I've rambled now for 13 minutes, up to 14 minutes, and I think that's probably enough, because we'll do a little bit in the studio as well, where I talk about the results, and a little bit about the matches, if I haven't already written about them. Which I probably will do once I've had a sleep. So, back to the studio. Have a good one, guys.
And we're back in the studio. People that are watching the video version will be fed up with seeing this t-shirt, because I'm recording. Yes, Sandy. That whine in the background was my dog, Sandy Claus. People sick of seeing this t-shirt because I've done so many recordings the last couple of days with wearing this that you probably think I own other ones, but it's only the second day. It's only a second day t-shirt. It's fine. It's clean. We're back in the studio. Community Pro Wrestling in Peterhead. What a show that was. I had such a blast. As you saw, I got loads of interviews. I got a montage, I got all the good stuff that you expect from a road trip episode of the SWN podcast, and it was just a really fun night. Gravy Davey really put on a show, and he also afforded me a little bit of time to be able to grab folk and get some interviews in. Some went better than others, and no fault of the wrestlers themselves, and I don't think even fault of myself, but kids did not take kindly to SBX, or Ellie Armstrong for that matter. As you may have seen, I've had to try and bust out some editing software. I've tried to blur out the background. It's worked for the most part. So, and I've had to cut off little bits at the end of the interview because kids are mean. That's what I learned. Well, I knew that already, but I've seen it up close and personal. But the full, extra couple seconds either end are available on Patreon for, just the whole video.
itself unedited. So if you want to find out if it was one of your kids that were being rough in their coarse language and words, you can go to Patreon, £1 plus VAT, patreon.com/ScottResnet. But as for the show itself, yeah, it was a great night. I've got a review up on the SWN website now, swnscotland.com. You can find out what my thoughts were at the time. That was only like a day after. This is Tuesday. The show was last Friday. So a little bit hazy on all the memories and all the finishes and all that kind of stuff. I just know that I enjoyed myself at the shows. I'll just go through the results, starting off with the VIP bonus match. I only caught the last little bit of this because I arrived. I'll be honest, I had general ticket, but when I got into the queue, I was called through. I didn't want to queue up right at the VIP time, so I missed the start of the match. But I saw the ending. I got to see Thorn Thermite's Insiguri, which seemed to be there was the highlight of the match anyway, so I'm glad I got to see it. But the Renegade Rex with JTT defeated Thorn Thermite by pinfall. I like looking at this Rex guy, Renegade Rex. He does look like he's the next evolution stage of Toby Michaels, for anyone who's aware of Toby Michaels. But it looks like a big skinny dude. And I like JTT as well. He had a good meanness about him. Meanness. Mean seems to be my buzzword this evening, or this afternoon. But yeah, they dragged Thermite to the back after the match, shouting that he was theirs now. But that was a nice little good starter as the crowd started to fill in. The venue was like an L shape, so I was at the lip of the L. Yeah, so it was like lip of the L. I went around the corner. The ring was on the angle of the L, and the entranceway was down like the long. Oh, the word I've got in my head is shaft. So apologies, that's the word we're going with. So the entranceway was near the shaft, and then it went down. Ring on the angle, and then came back round to where I was sitting. But no, it filled out very quickly. It was a good crowd in Peterhead. They had the lower setting ring, which always sent me on edge. I don't like the lower setting ring. I think it just makes it look too close to the floor, looks too close to the action. I don't know what it is, but I can put that to the back of my head though when I'm watching the shows. I can enjoy it. I'll see in a rating that's different to whatever I've been used to for the last 30 odd years. Not 30, not that old. 25 odd years. It's just something about it I don't like. But wrestling itself was great. So kicked off with Big Ross Hauser and Charlie Watson. Big Ross getting the win. Charlie Watson, I think may have said it in my big 40-minute rant a moment ago, but I think that was one of his first match, if not his first match, and he really had everything together. He was very vocal. He was very animated. His in-ring stuff was solid. There was nothing like, oh my God, you've hesitated too much and all that kind of stuff that someone who's so jaded to watching wrestling would see. So he had a great performance. Big Ross was great. I said in my written review that I enjoy watching him because he just looks like a really excited child. Like, he's just so excited. He's going to see wrestling. He's going to wrestle someone. He's going to beat someone up. And he does. And then he goes, yes, I've beaten them up. It's ace. It's just great. It's fantastic. I like watching wrestlers enjoying wrestling. And then when you see a bad guy enjoying themselves being a bad guy, it's just, oh, perfect. Perfect combination. But no, a great little match to kick off the show. Big Ross is a very popular for the CPW crowd, and it very much was like that. It was like nothing I've seen before. I mean, I go to shows in Aberdeen, I go to WrestleZone, and what have you, and they have a core family show. Everyone's screaming, shouting, but they all kind of have that little bit of respect going on. They're a bit shy, but reserved when they come to trying to attack wrestlers. I don't know what Davey's done, but he's brought Govan to Peterhead. Because these kids were animals, absolute animals. They were out for blood a lot of the time, and they wanted to batter you with inflatable hammers. They wanted to throw insults and chops and punches, and it was just madness watching it. Next up was Nicole Jasmine defeating Ellie Armstrong. I was very excited to see these two because I hadn't seen Ross or Charlie either, or Renegade Rex and Thorn Thermite. But I was excited to see Ellie Armstrong. Ellie Armstrong's been a big favorite of mine for a while. Since I've seen her since I interviewed her way back when she maybe had a couple matches on the WWE Network behind closed doors. So get to see her actually wrestle, get to meet her as well, was a delight. Really enjoyed meeting Ellie. And get to see her wrestle as well. She's a really great character. I think there's so much more that she has to do. It's not just a one-dimensional bad guy character. She can throw things like the veganism in, but she doesn't need to at this stage because she didn't need to for this particular match. But she has got something that I'm very excited to see where it goes. I think she's got a very strong future. I really enjoy seeing Nicole Jasmine as well. Nicole Jasmine's career kind of journey has been on social media. She's very open about her struggles and how she got here and how proud she is to be a wrestler. And to see her wrestle was a delight as well. I've seen some things on YouTube. Again, I think I put this in the written review, that sometimes she's a little bit hesitant, hesitant. That's probably the best word for it. But she was really on form with this one. Don't know whether Ellie's just a really comfortable opponent for her, but she was on fire. She was really great watching her. It was really great watching her wrestle. It was just a really fun match. It was simple. It was, the crowd really ate up the hate on Ellie. Nicole Jasmine got a lot of plaudits and fan interaction as well. A lot of claps, lots of cheers. Nothing more you could really want from that particular match. So it was really great, really good. And our first half main event was the CPW Heavyweight Championship in a four-way. SBX, Darrow, and Mayhem Brooks came up short against the champion, Thatcher Wright. And again, I can't put into words, I can't articulate how cold the CPW venue got, how cold Peterhead Football Club got when Thatcher Wright came out with that music he's got, with Margaret Thatcher speaking. It literally was, a shiver went up my spine and the venue just kind of went down a bit. I don't know whether someone's playing with the heating when Thatcher enters the ring, but it was just, you could feel it was like a Dementor had arrived to Peterhead Social Football Club. And it just, something so weird about it. The match itself, chaos. It was a four-way. There was chaotic. People, there's bodies everywhere. Will they, won't they win? Everyone had a good chance at winning, and it was just a case of who survived. It was Thatcher with his big Thatcher book, his big book of the big, I don't know what the opposite of the Bible is. That's all made up anyway. Smacking again. I think it was Mayhem Brooks. I'm gonna have to. That's what I think happened. Could be Darrow, but I'm sure it was Mayhem Brooks. Got planted with this book and was pinned for Thatcher to retain. Again, chaos. It was a four-way. Thatcher Wright, super unpopular. SBX had that kind of tweener thing going on where he didn't like Thatcher particularly either, but he didn't like the crowd. So there was a bit of a weird thing going, yeah, you're beating up Thatcher, but I don't like you either, SBX. So that was that. Darrow and Mayhem Brooks had a good little back and forth encounters and what have you. I would gladly see that again. I made the suggestion of possibly tag team in the future, Termination Z and Mayhem, a partner of his choosing. That would be fun. I think there's a lot of open-ended scope there for Community Pro to use. So there's plenty of good stuff for that. After that, Ryan Richards defeated the Wanderer. During the interval, we got a couple of interviews. I've done the montage, so it does the montage of the first half. Interviews, I've got the interval. Montage, interviews I got afterwards, you know, keeping it simple. After the interval, Ryan Richards defeated the Wanderer. Again, hadn't seen Ryan Richards or the Wanderer wrestle before. The Wanderer, he's got such this booming voice for someone who looks about 17. I don't understand it, but he's got such a booming voice, and the people enjoyed the Wanderer and trying to get him to sing along, and Richards trying to offer money for him to shut up, and it was just good fun. There's a little bit where Wanderer accepted the 10 grand that he wanted there and then in cash, and Richards was searching his pockets, went up to the referee asking me if he had the money on him. That was just a funny little bit I really enjoyed. I'm excited to see what more Ryan Richards does in the future, because he's got a very good look. I loved it when I was seeing him after the show. He was in a suit, which just, he was very sharply dressed, and I think he makes himself the character, and that makes, he believes it, and it makes it all the better for it. Lee McRae defeated Martin McAllister in an unscheduled match. It was supposed to be McRae versus Ravy Davey, and Martin McAllister turned up, and I was glad to see him. I hadn't seen Martin McAllister before at Wrestling Live. I interviewed him. I've seen him on YouTube a little bit. I've seen his plight to pick up a win. Unfortunately, this was not the night. I think he's now 0-43 as of that match. I think he was 0-44 the next night at Iron Girders. So it was just great to see him. He's very good, great underdog. I guess he's light up boots. And Lee McRae looked really solid for someone who's very new. Came out of GPWA, and he looks like he has everything together. Bit of a cocky fighter guy. There's a lot of them a little bit at the moment. Like Ryan Richards kind of got the same kind of thing, but he adds the richness factor to it. And we've got Mayhem Brooks as well, who's got the fighter factor to it. So Lee McRae is kind of that middle point as well of the two. Get a faction, all three of them. I love it. And then we had the 5-on-5 elimination tag team Peterhead Street Fight, which was it was eventually called, between the Govan team, the Vicious Lads, and Leighton Buzzard against the Pack. And this is just chaos. So it started off as a 5-on-5 eventually. Govan team came out, Ravy Davey and Cousin Xander announced that Steg had got lost somewhere, so Ravy Davey filled in for him. Asked for some tag team partners after the Pack came out, because there was five of them, and there's either going to be 2-on-5, or but the Pack kindly said that if they can get three more partners, they would have a 5-on-5. Leighton Buzzard came out, big reaction. Great to see Leighton Buzzard. I think I've only seen him once or twice before when ICW were up in Aberdeen, maybe? I'm not sure. Something like that. So it was great to see him in his last CPW appearance before he goes off to Japan. And after that, we thought it was going to be 3-on-5. And then a couple of VLs came out. Rocky Ross and E-Town of the Vicious Lads. And interesting characters. Interesting characters. Just a couple of lads. A couple of lads that have stumbled into Peterhead with their gear, with their like Hawaiian shirts, their beach shirts, and everything like that. Just like they've come from Benidorm or something like that. They've just turned up at Majorca. They've turned up to Peterhead for a match, and they were a good laugh. They seemed quite reserved, a little bit shy. I think the more we see them, the more we see the Vicious Lads, the more outrageous the antics will become, which we'll enjoy, sure, as fans. But yeah, once it came down to 3-on-3, weapons started getting thrown in. So Ravy Davey got on the microphone and was just like, oh, you know what, you want to use some weapons? Well, I'm gonna make this a Peterhead Street Fight. And then they went everywhere. The montage, I only caught some bits of it, because it was just chaos. Bodies, weapons everywhere. It was just absolute madness. And eventually Leighton Buzzard was down to, it was 1-on-2, Leighton Buzzard got the win, everyone was happy, and we got a little bit of a tribute to Leighton from Ravy Davey at the end there, talking about beating him while he was doing a carpet with Crowbar, and Leighton was just happy to help, to try and help as much as he can, because he came up from England, just packed up everything to become a wrestler, to come up to GPWA, become a wrestler, and now he's off to Japan, which is accomplishing one of his main goals when he came up here. It was great to see Leighton Buzzard. I got a handshake with him after the show. That was about all I got. I would have loved to get a little video, a little bit of a minute with him, but the guy was just running about to no end after the show, trying to get pictures trying to give all the kids and families photos, which is what he should be doing. He's a wrestler. That's how it should work. But that's it. We're on the road. Show 2. Hope you're enjoying the road trip episode so far. And enjoy the rest of the season. Have a good one.
A few moments later.
I was a bit premature running down the card there and just stopped. I actually heard a gate. I thought my door was about to go, and I thought I'll just wrap up just in case. But it was a great night, Peterhead. I went in with, I don't know what expectations I had in the show. I knew I was going to see a lot of new faces for the first time. I was going to hopefully get a hold of some people as well. I said in the drive home segment that this felt like the most job on the job episode or show I've ever been to, because I was really conscious about what to get some people to speak to. I wanted to do that. And you know what? It was really easy to do. Like it was, a lot of guys came up to me, like all the guys and girls came up to me, just we were having a chat, and as someone who's very anxious socially, it was just lovely. It was really nice. And I keep using the phrase, they put the community into community pro wrestling, but it really was. It was just great seeing the wrestlers enjoy themselves as well as the fans enjoying themselves, and everyone was there to support each other. There was like no egos or anything like that. It was just a really, really pleasant night of wrestling, and that I enjoyed immensely being there. Sure, would have I liked to maybe punch a child if there was no repercussions? Maybe, perhaps. But otherwise, it was just great to start meeting people that I've spoken to over Zoom and through the podcast. Like, I think I've interviewed the vast majority of people that are on that show that I've never seen wrestle live before. Ellie, Nicole, Martin, The Wanderer, Ravy Davey. I have seen Ravy Davey before, that's a lie. But again, to actually see these guys wrestle and do what they enjoyed doing live for the first time was just, it was great. It was great. It was a great night. Like I say, it's a little bit different to what you get if you're going to an hour show, if you're going to WrestleZone, for example. As I said, they're a bit more of a shy young crowd, and they'll do high fives, but they're a little bit timid, but they'll shout along, they'll do the yays and the boos, but they're a little bit timid when it comes to actually meeting the wrestlers. But the kids that came to Peterhead to this show were just feral. So it was just like they've brought Govan to Peterhead, and it's just fascinating. I don't know how Davey's done it. The power of Prime, I suppose, and Sugar. But yeah, he's doing a great job as Ravy Davey. He's really putting the work in. He's creating something. I had a bit of a reservation when they're running, I don't say territories, but they're running places that place other promotions did. But he seems to be really building something that's different. It's not something you'll see everywhere. It's fueled towards that not too young kids, not teenagers, that kind of middle ground, that your 10-year-olds kind of thing, where they're just gonna get loaded up on Sugar, on Prime, on Fizzy Juice, and just go mad and see some wrestling. So he's got his little niche in there. He's got a niche in there in this market, and I am looking forward to seeing where it goes, what happens next with community pro wrestling. I'm definitely gonna keep an eye on it. But no, I'm definitely wrapping it up this time. This last little bit, that was a weird. The last bit, I just went, oh, that's it, done. Fade out, and then fade back in. Here I am. But I hope people get along to a show, get along to any show that's near you. We will try to advertise and plug as many promotions as we feature as we can. So hopefully you'll find a show near you through our calendar. But this has been a great experience so far. I'm only two shows in, so I'm going to our show this weekend. For Battle of the Nations, which will be next week's episode, fingers crossed. Hopefully a little bit easier when it comes to editing, because I only have one to edit. I'm not trying to juggle six edits of podcasts and what have you. But that's a story for another time. So definitely going this time. So thank you for supporting SWN any way you can. Patreon is great. It's £1 plus VAT, so it's like £1.20. And you can get all these episodes early and check out all our archive content as well. And you can check us out on Scott Resnett just on social media, and swnscotland.com. Great, I'm going to go put my teeth back in. But have a good rest of day. If you're watching this right now as it comes out, have a good evening, and I'll see you next week. Have a good one. Sorry, just sneaking in one last time. It's after the credits, it'll be fine. We did get one question. We got a couple of questions in from Callum. I'm just going to answer them, and then I'm definitely gone this time. Honest, third time lucky. Just ask, how was the drive to my neck of the woods? Was fine. I was meant to stop off in Mintlaw. I got confused with my own memory and ended up all the way to Methlick, and had to do had to turn back, go through Old Deer, go over like this little weak bridge end to get to Mintlaw. Actually quite exciting to go over a weak bridge. I don't know why. It was just one of those things. And plus, why can't CPW open their doors 30 minutes later so I can go literally less than a quarter mile to my house? Just missed the first match. Just come along. Missed the first match. That's just get a ticket. Come, you'll get the second half at least. At the very least, you'll get the second half. And just come along. I'm sure if you contacted CPW, they would be fine. As long as, I do think they need to know, as long as you come and you have your ticket. You just missed, you just missed the first match. Or missed maybe first two matches. First half. You'll get to see the second half, which is probably where you'll get Navy Davey and whatnot. So, yeah, no excuse. Anyway, right, definitely go this time. Fade in now. Fade in now. Fade in now.